your life becomes so comfortable if the stomach is filled with fluid, as this female patient has. I don't know why, but she went on drinking water, and I am in the epigastric region, and straight away by placing the probe transversely in the epigastric region, here you can see a band of tissue which is the pancreas. So easy to see, this is the body of the pancreas, this is the subclinic vein, the landmark for the pancreas, and this is stomach. This is all stomach filled with fluid. It's not a mass, because in this, if you change it longitudinally, you will see fluid material within it. And below this cystic area, which is the stomach, is the pancreas, with subclinic vein coursing its posterior border. And if we see, you can also make up the relationship of the pancreatic tail with the left kidney. This is the left kidney, though blurred in transverse section. This is the tail of the pancreas. This is the subclinic vein. This is the body of the pancreas, and this is the stomach. Now there is another cystic area seen. Head of the pancreas. This area is the head of the pancreas in transverse section. This is the superior mesenteric vein. This is premesenteric artery. This is the aorta. And this cystic structure is not gallbladder, it is the duodenum. Why? Because see, when I maneuver the probe, it changes its shape, and you can see small particles floating in it. That is the water. And look at it. It changes its shape. You can see ring down artifacts, bowel gas, stomach. Now, these two cystic areas, this is the duodenum filled with water, and this is the stomach filled with water, these black areas. This is the liver in between these two structures. And don't be misguided by focal lesion or a pancreatic pseudocyst. As you can see that the pancreas is absolutely normal. Behind this, these cystic areas, we did see that the pancreas is absolutely normal, and there were no changes. This is the pancreas, though fatty. Pancreas is fatty. And see, this is the stomach. And here you can see particles. These are the tiny particles within it. And when I move the probe below postural margin, angle it, these areas, cystic areas, change their shape. So this is the duodenum. This area is the duodenum, this one. And so this one is the stomach. Below is the pancreas in transverse section. Here it is in transverse section, and you can see that subclinic vein is coursing posterior to the body of the pancreas. This is the subclinic vein. This is the body of the pancreas, fatty, and this is the stomach. This is the artifact because of the pressure, and it will disappear. Now you are seeing this artifact. This artifact, it will disappear if I release the pressure. Now see, there are. So this is the benefit of seeing the. If you ever come across a patient with bowels filled to this extent with water, as you are seeing in this case, that you can analyze the pancreas beautifully. This is the pancreatic head longitudinal section. This is the aorta. This is the superior mesenteric artery rising from it. This is the celiac artery. So this is, this segment of the study was to give you some information regarding the ultrasound of the normal pancreas with overfilled stomach and duodenum.